The prediction isn't meant to be exact, but it should be close.
I can say I've loved every day of it. I enjoy coming into work. It can be a very stressful and trying job at sometimes, but it's also very rewarding. And I'm lucky very much to find a place where I come to school and I'm very passionate about what I do. And I just love progressing kids no matter where they're at. I take them from where they're at, I just try to move them up that ladder. And if it were up to me, I would almost call my classes Problem Solving 101. Because that's what math is, you're just solving problems. You're taking, you know, what you know about a certain situation, you're taking information that's given, and how do you use that information that you know and what's given to come up with a solution?
Well, he'll show us examples of it. Like, we were looking at just earlier how you could tell and deal in like halves or thirds and how you would make it into like real world equations. Like, so in the slope situation, you can pretty much see when you're gonna hit a target.
He also taught us a bit about property and how, you know, how much money it'll actually be per square foot. Like, if you buy, let's say, like 11 cents per square foot, that's going to be more than it actually is.
Tell you what, come up with an answer, write it down, and compare it with the person next to you.
I just don't want to be up here talking and telling them. I like to engage them and get their minds working. And I also try to encourage collaboration. The way I seat my students in the room is everybody has an elbow partner or somebody sitting right next to them. So that way, it multiplies the number of conversations that are going on a certain topic. Instead of me talking to one student, now every student can have that conversation, and again, it just increases the free-flowingness of the ideas and the thought process behind solving these problems. So I like the concept of the elbow partners because it does encourage the small group conversation, but then we immediately switch back to the large group conversation after a certain amount of time.
Yeah, because then for real world, you'll always have someone helping you. Like, whenever you get married or something, you'll always have your husband or wife helping you. You'll never just be alone.
And you're probably always going to have a partner when you work, someone who has the exact same thing or has similar things.
We have a great community here at Cedar Valley, and the kids are motivated, they're excited. They're not always excited about math, but what I try to instill in them is that, again, it's not just math, it's problem solving. You know, the world needs problem solvers. How can you think on your feet? How can you pay attention and not miss the little details? Because those are things that are sought after by employers. Attention to detail, being able to think on your feet and come up with a solution.
What's zero, the slope or y-intercept?
The
y-intercept, so it goes to the origin.